Dance with Devils.
Yeah, I was just reading about that one. It looks really cool.
I mean, that one looks like it's gonna be a what do you call them? Reverse harem. It's a
one of those shows.
Yeah, it's gonna be like a bunch of guys with a girl.
Hold on, just interpret.
Reverse harem?
I don't think it's reverse harem.
Oh.
There's a term. It's a God. There was that game too that I auditioned for that actually used that term.
Yeah, I have no idea. Honestly.
Otome game.
The other one that looks interesting is Comet Lucifer.
Comet Lucifer.
Yeah, it's got the picture of.
Oh,
like,
okay. It's
I'm
right
not even
across
looking,
left. Okay.
Yeah, I'm not even looking at the description. I'm just kind of looking at the picture and going like, oh, does it look cool? Yeah, it looks cool. Like, with half of these things, it's like you never know what you're going to get unless it's a season two of it.
And even then, we cannot guarantee that season two will be all that grand.
Oh, I expect it to be all that grand. I mean...
Well, look at Vampire Knight. I've heard so many rages about the second season.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Every person I talked to so far with Vampire Knight
hates it.
They hated season two.
I see. Well, I mean, then there's the new series that's coming out with what is that name of the series? It's ended here.
Oh!
I can't think of it.
Start from the end.
Yeah, thank you.
You're
welcome. Yeah, I'm not even gonna say the Japanese name of it because it's
Orari no set of Nagoya yeah. Kessenhen.
Yeah, what he said. Because I am terrible with Japanese names.
My excuse is I'm half Japanese, so I can somehow pronounce these for no reason.
Yeah, it still doesn't sometimes.
And sometimes I can't even pronounce them anyways because the yeah. name's 50 exactly. letters long. And I'm like, what is this?
Exactly. So those are some of the series. Definitely really Sarah for the End is like one of the ones I'm looking forward to. I mean, they got a new Gundam coming out, which
interesting.
I love Gundam.
I know you love Gundam. For me, it's like I'm just tired of Gundam.
I don't know. Gundam 00 was really good until the movie.
I think my thing is I don't like mech anime, and the reason why is Escaflowne, the movie, ruined it for me. Escaflowne ruined mech anime altogether.
Oh, Escaflowne.
Because that was my real introduction to mech anime.
Oh, I hate Escaflowne.
That was
much.
My introduction to mech anime, really. And it ruined it. For next season or fall season, of course, Yuri, season 3. There's no words for me to describe how amazed I am that there's a third season and I'm going to watch it.
Are you going to watch the crap out of it?
Oh, God, yes. I watched the crap out of my Blu-rays of season 1.
How about season 2?
I don't own season 2 yet, but I will.
How dare you not own season 2?
I know. I'm not a real fan without season 2.
No, you're not.
And I want to end this one anime. It sounds really weird for me to say this. If you know what this anime is, it's called Valkyrie Drive Mermaid. And it's an ecchi Yuri anime. And the reason why I really want to see this is because it seems like this one company is putting most of their resources into this franchise because it's an anime, a smartphone game, and a console game. And they're all interconnected.
Yeah.
And
but I also think it's going to be really – Valkyrie Drive also I think is going to be really, really close to a hentai.
Yeah, I think it's going to have those
– Sounds like it.
It's going to have a lot of those pervy moments. But really, the reason why I do want to see it is because of the fact I want to see if this company is going to end up sinking because of it.
Yeah.
Or this game/anime is going to be a saving grace.
Yeah, I mean, there's other stuff out there, too. There's, like, a ton more series that look interesting, so...
Yeah, especially
but granted,
the one with a chibi and...
Yeah, granted, I could be wrong, because there's some series out there that looked really good last season, and just, they failed horribly. Like, One of the series that looked really good last season and looked very interesting was, what is it? Can I find you? Was Classroom Crisis. And that just did absolutely nothing for me.
Really? I didn't even see Classroom Crisis because I was afraid it was going to be...
It was just kind of blah.
That's what I figured. And,
there's a few other ones that are out there that are just yeah, maybe watch the first episode. I didn't even get past the first episode of Classroom Crisis because it was just too boring.
Ah.
It was just way too boring, but you just never know what's going to be.
Well, at least we could look at the bright side.
Well, what's the bright side?
Komori-san is going to be one of those shows hopefully you and I will like because of the creator.
Oh, yeah. It's
I can't understand what my husband is saying.
Yes. Hey, Celeste, have you seen that series yet?
Nope.
You should totally see that series.
What is it so called? Good.
I can't understand what my husband is saying.
Oh, that sounds entertaining already.
It is very entertaining. It's only 6 minutes, mostly.
I thought it was less than that, really.
It's 4 minutes or something like that. It's not long.
But it's so good, and it has a lot of heart to it.
And there's just so much going on all the time. It's high energy half the time.
Mm-hmm. It demands your attention, and it does a good job at keeping your attention.
Yeah.
And I'm hoping this new series is going to do the same thing. I hope.
Yeah, so it's going to be interesting. It's going to be... I don't know what to expect. But seeing how it's going to be short, it's going to be possibly entertaining. Hopefully it's not going to be the last time we ran into something that was similar to... I can't understand what my husband is saying. And that was the tank... The one with the tanks and the chibis.
The tanks and the chibis.
I don't know, that sounds pretty awesome.
It was over-sexualized chibis.
Oh god, yeah, I remember now. I had to think about that.
Yeah, because there's a lot. Because
there's panty shots and everything.
Yeah, cool. It's military.
And really, the storyline just wasn't that good.
It was just blah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Actually, this one thing I've actually not seen anything of either is Lupin the Third.
That's still around.
Yeah, it's actually just opened up
a new series
last season.
Oh wow, that's crazy. Yeah, that's major nostalgia.
Yeah, I mean,
and the art style for the new series actually it has that nostalgia old school vibe to it.
Yeah,
but it looks like it keeps up to date to some degree.
Oh yeah. Well, you kind of have to with certain things.
I mean, I think if I recall correctly, the art style is supposed to be similar to that really, I don't want to say the adult loop in the third anime, but I'm going to call it the adult loop in the third anime because I can't remember the name of it.
The adult loop in the third anime?
Yeah, it's, nice. I can't remember the name of it.
You're talking about the one with Fujikyo?
Yeah, Fujiko, right?
Fujiko, yeah, where basically in the opening sequence you see boobies!
And in episode 3, the first thing she does is have sex with Inspector Gata.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
That's
why,
I don't know, I've always loved Fujiko, and that's one of the reasons why.
Why, because she just doesn't give a shit?
Yeah, pretty much.
Just doesn't care. Half the time it's just whatever.
Just see
you
guys. Gonna go do crap now.
Here we go. Lupin the Third, the woman called Fujiko Mine.
Yeah. That's exactly it.
It's supposed to be I think it's the same animation team that did that one.
Yeah.
But hopefully not as, I want to say not as, hopefully not as sexualized.
Mm-hmm.
Only because I do because of that nostalgia part of my brain saying this is how Lupin the Third should be.
Yeah.
And it looks like this kind of follows that same pattern as the old ones.
That's true. The surprising thing is I've not seen it on Crunchyroll at all.
That is true. So either A, no one is picking it up, or B, Funimation's gonna pick it up.
Yeah, they might, which would be really cool to see, but I mean, it's like, I haven't seen it on Funimation site, I haven't seen it on Crunchyroll. It's
well,
just
they
not been
say it's a summer
available.
leftover, but I'm wondering if it means summer leftover in Italy, not in Japan.
I would say it's a summer leftover because it started last season, so.
But I thought it started in Japan this fall.
No.
Really?
Yeah. It started last season.
Why am I thinking that it's... I don't know. For some odd reason, I keep wanting to... it's throwing me off now.
Yeah. So while you're doing that, let's get into a little bit of the news right now.
Okay.
We're starting to run out of time, I think. Because my phone died on me where I was keeping track of the hour-long thing. Well, so I have no idea.
Oh, haha. Japan, yeah. Okay, regular broadcasting in Japan will begin October 2nd, 2015.
Okay, so it hasn't started in Japan yet.
Right, and it started in Italy August 30th.
Okay, that's interesting. So we might get it, we still might get it then.
Right.
So we still might just get it when Japan gets it.
Exactly.
That is very, very interesting that Italy gets it before Japan, but
they said they would.
Yeah. I knew the fact that they said they would because it's because I believe it was created in it's not really an anime, but it is an anime.
It's actually done by a Japanese anime studio, but it's actually done with but it's done for Italy in mind.
Yeah. So basically it makes sense. That the reason why they would say they let Italy have it before anyone else.
Mm-hmm.
So going on to some of the news now. Is that 17-year-old J-pop idol was fined 650,000 yen, which is roughly around $5,386 in damages by the Tokyo District Court on September 18th. The court ruled that she violated her contract with her management company by associating with the opposite sex. The girl had signed the contract in March 2013 and debuted in a six-girl idol group in July. The group dissolved in October. However, when it was learned that the girl in question accepted an invitation to a hotel room by two male fans, yeah, the girl argued that not dating is not an indispensable aspect of being a girl idol, but the judge disagreed. Discovering romantic relationships damages the image of idols, he ruled, to gain the support of male fans. Clauses banning romantic relations are necessary. Kojima blamed the girl for the dissolution of the idol group. Yeah, dissolution of the idol group, and fined her for part of her clothing and lesson costs. Wow.
Yep.
That's a mouthful right there.
Well. It also says, in Japan, celebrities are widely expected to lead a highly moral, chaste lives and project an image of purity to their fans. So there is that. And it's kind of interesting because how Americans see or how they experience their pop idols versus how Japanese have their pop idols are very different.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I mean, actually what it reminds me more of, though, is... Reminds me more of Disney.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Definitely with Disney because they're more high moral, chaste lives, basically. I don't know if Disney actually allows them. I think Disney allows dating, but...
Mm-hmm.
But still, it's like, it reminds me if you want to, like, look at something that's a little bit closer. But, I mean, yeah, definitely the celebrities... Definitely are a big, huge difference because if the celebrities we have over here went to Japan, man, oh boy.
Yeah. Well, I don't know. I mean, Japan really loves Lady Gaga.
Oh, it's Lady Gaga. I mean, to be honest with you, it's like...
She's awkward and Japan loves awkward.
Gaga.
She works well with freaking... What's her face? Hatsumiku.
Hatsune Miku. Yeah,
I can see that.
So it's like, the thing is, with her, when they were making this big, when it made headlines that, you know, she was, Hatsune Miku was,
opening for Lady Gaga.
Yeah. It's not a big shock there because it's like,